Let's play big bank, take love bank. You are looking at a shark in a fish tank. When I'm in the kitchen, I make plenty cash. Tell shawty Carmel, she got plenty ass.
Yeah, I love the strippers. 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 In my foreign car.
Welcome to episode 18 of Keepin' It A Hundo. Today's guest is Diamond. She's an exotic dancer. Some may call her a stripper. Some may even call her a scripper. She refers to herself as a professional dancer. And I'm by no means a strip club connoisseur, but I have been to strip clubs all over the place. Different countries, different cities around the U.S. And there's definitely things that are regional, things that are cultural, that kind of separate the behavior at each club. And that goes for the behavior of the dancers, of the patrons. I'm not a big strip club guy, but when I do go, I'm not really involved. I'm kind of chilling in the back. I like the music. I like the social aspect of it. Of course, I like looking at the girls, but I'm not big into the lap dances and the champagne room and all that stuff. Diamond's going to break all that down for us. We're going to find out what really goes on inside these walls of these clubs. And of course, we got to find out if there really is sex in the champagne room. This is my conversation with professional dancer Diamond.
Got the trunk by the engine, so when I bad, I'm frontin' on you niggas. Yeah, I love the strippers. Yeah, I love the strippers. Yeah, I love the strippers. Yeah, I love the strippers.
So what clubs have you worked at? Are you from Miami or are you from Broward?
I'm from Miami. I was born and raised in Miami Gardens. So, yes, I'm from Miami.
That's the strip club area. Yeah. That's where they're all at.
Yeah, that's where I started at, basically, probably like 6 years ago.
That's how old are you now?
30.
And you started where, the office?
Yeah. I started at the office probably like around 2010.
And you've worked at a bunch of clubs in Miami? You worked at Coco's?
Never worked at Coco's.
Never Coco's? G5?
Worked at G5.
Take One?
Worked at Take One. Worked at the Rolex.
You know Summer Rain?
No.
She's a bartender. She used to work at Take One a lot. Now she's over at the office.
No.
She's a friend of mine.
No, I don't know.
So what's your favorite one to work at?
My favorite club to work at is, I'm going to say, in Palm Beach. It's in Palm Beach. It's not in Miami. So, Miami really is just hangout spots right now. It's really not a strip club. Like, basically, I just think that it's more money and out of town than in Miami and Broward and stuff like that. So, I just go north to make more money.
Do you notice a difference between... Like, you kind of racially profile or profile... It might not be race, but you profile customers based on, like, oh, this guy's 55 and he's wearing a nice suit, as opposed to this dude's 22 and he's got a pair of J's on and, you know, he's got jeans and a t-shirt. You know what I mean? Like, you profile that stuff? Or, like, black guys don't tip as good as white guys, or white guys don't tip as good as black guys? Like...
No, I don't actually do that, because sometimes you never know what somebody has in their pocket. So I don't judge a book by its cover, because that white guy can you've been going through hard times and don't have any money right now. Probably have a couple of dollars to tip you, and that black guy probably will, you know, throw a lot of money, or, you know, if it's swap it out, either or. So I don't racially profile anybody.
How do guys feel about your job? Do you have issues dating guys?
I have a lot of issues of dating guys. They're very jealous.
Right. At first, I'm sure they're cool with it. And then soon
as
they...
No, they're never cool with it.
Nah.
I mean, not the guys that I come around with. They're never cool with it. They always want a lot of attention. They always want dinner, breakfast, lunch, sex. Dinner, breakfast, lunch, sex. And it's like a movie, so they're never cool with it. Because I work hard, so it's like I'm never home. So guys always... you know, be jealous of me giving more time to the script club than more time to them.
So what kind of hours are you working?
I'll pull a 24-hour if I have to.
On like a Memorial Day weekend.
Memorial Day weekend, right? Because some clubs don't never close. Like some clubs is open the 24 hours, so you can pull a 24 hours in that whole day.
24 hours. The only one I know is 11. You worked at 11 before?
No.
Did what other ones are 24?
They had a new club called 24, in Oak Block of Florida. They closed down, I think. And, you know, the office had the club open 24 hours Memorial Day weekend. Like, okay. They never closed, so.
Have you dated customers?
Wait,
do you even call them customers? What do you call them? Is it like a slang name for what you guys call?
No, I think we call them customers. Basically, yeah. So, if I get attached to somebody, then they'll be a good friend. You know, it don't really be like customers.
And what do you call yourself? You consider yourself a stripper?
No.
Are you a dancer?
No. I'm a professional dancer.
Professional dancer. That's right. So every question I ask that has stripper in it, do I have to change it to professional dancer?
Right. Because I have my license to dance.
Really?
Right.
So how do you get a license to dance?
In Miami-Dade, you don't have to have a license. Mm-hmm. In Broward, you don't have to have a license, but in Palm Beach, you have to have a license. And
really?
So that's more where I work at. So
you just apply for a license, or you have to pass like a dance test?
No, basically, is you're just going to apply for it.
Okay.
And they give it to you.
I apologize in advance if I use the term stripper, if that offends you.
Yeah.
But I think I'm so used to saying it that mm-hmm. I might say it a few times.
You don't have to apologize. I mean, you know, there's like, oh, let's go to the script club. They're not going to say, oh, let's go to a professional dancer club.
Right, exactly. So, and people wouldn't even know what the hell you're talking about.
Right, right, right.
Where does the name Diamond come from?
It's this movie
Pretty called... sure it's not from your mom.
No, definitely not. It's this movie called The Players Club.
Yep.
Okay.
I know it.
She reminded me so much of me when the movie first came out that I stole her name, because her name was Diamond in the movie. So she reminded me so much of me, like, you know, just in there trying to get out, the pretty girl and, you know, everybody. You know, some girls be like, don't nobody have, like, you could say, like, special clients. Like, people just come in the club to see you. And I always have people that just come in the clubs to see me. So girls have a problem with that. So I just see myself, you know.
What other stage names have you used? Or have you been Diamond since day one?
Yeah, I've been Diamond since day one.
For real?
Yeah. I didn't have to use another name.
Today's guest is Diamond. She's a professional dancer and works at professional dance clubs all over South Florida. Mm-hmm. And she's looking very blonde today, but I'm pretty sure she's not a natural blonde.
No.
But I'm going to take her word for it for now. So your Instagram profile says you're a mixed breed. What are you mixed with?
My daddy is kind of like Canadian. He's like white, black. And my mom is Jamaican. So I was born in Canada. I came here when I was 9.
I just heard it. You just said Canada, the way they say it.
Mm-hmm.
So how'd you get into the dancing?
When I was growing up, it was kind of like rough for me to like get by with bills and stuff like that. And, you know, minimum wage in Florida was not paying shit. So it's like you get a job, you know, at these fast food restaurants and your check is like $150. Like, you can't pay no bills with that. So I just tried it out. And my first night, I made $600. And I went back and I made more and more, and I just got accustomed to the fast money and what it brings and what lifestyle it brings.
It's tough to get away from it once you get it, right?
Right.
Are you open about your profession with your family?
My family just found out probably like 3 years ago, because I was not open, and my family is kind of like judgmental. So it's like I wasn't really open with them. But now that I'm open, like, I could just go, like, if I go shopping with my sister and I pull out ones, you know, she know where it's coming from, you know. Like, usually I have to be like, oh, you know, secretive shop with her and stuff like that. So now I'm open with my family. That's more than being closed behind doors and your family don't know what you do.
And are you open with guys when you meet them right away, or do you hold it back sometimes because you don't want them to know, or what?
I hold it back sometimes because they think
you don't want to be judged.
I don't want to be judged, and then they think I'm giving up pussy just off the back of, you know, just because I'm a dancer. You know, dancers are easy, but every dancer is different.
Right, just like women. There's easy women, there's not right, easy. It's just everybody's different.
Right, right, right. Like, it takes me a long time to have sex with that person. I'm just not going to just have sex with you just because, just to have sex. Like, I have to get to know you.
You mentioned the ones, and your sister sees you pull out the ones. Do you ever bring, like a grocery bag full of ones into the bank or anything like that?
Yeah, My party 2016, I had to bring $9,000 in the bank of ones. I'm going to show you.
Yeah, I want to see a picture of that.
$9,000 in the bank of ones, and they were so mad at me because they had to stop and count the ones. It was funny because how they looked at it, they was like, oh my God, all these, what are we going to do? And I'm like, hey, like, you know, I need to switch it out because I can't walk around with all these ones, so I'm going to show you a picture. See?
That's 9,000, or that's most of it?
Because that's, it's most, like, that's most of it. That's 6,000. See, this is the rest of it because I was still counting.
Yeah, we might have to post these.
Okay.
I'll repost them. You can find Diamond on Instagram at gorgeous_diamond_foreign.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Precipitating in there, a lot of rain.
Yeah.
Thunderstorms that day.
Yeah.
Where in Canada are you from? Toronto?
Montreal and Toronto, both of them.
Okay. Yeah. I love it up there. I've been there a bunch of times. If you had to break down the percentage of women in your profession that are turning tricks, what would you say?
Percentage. So are we talking about like
half the girls are turning tricks?
So you say, like, oh, say we have 100%. We're going to start with 100%.
Every girl that works in a strip club.
Majority turns of tricks. All of them.
Okay.
I mean,
very high.
Very high. Because you have the girl, you have the, I'm going to just say this, you have the it girls. The it girls are the pretty girls. Just, you know, we hang around each other.
They're going to get money no matter
what.
We're
going to make money, whatever. And then you have the girls that's not so pretty and the girls that don't know how to dance and they have to do anything to get by. Like, you know, in the dressing room, it's a different kind of story. It's like we're hearing about who have to pay their hotel fees and who
has pimps. Because they're visiting from out of town.
Some still stay here, but they don't have a house.
Okay.
So they're living at the hotels,
right.
Or some has pimps.
They're working for somebody in there.
Right. So in the dressing room, it's a whole lot of...
How many of them are working for pimps? Is that common, or is that just every... I mean, do you see it a lot?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. In my days of dressing, I saw it a whole lot of people getting pimped out, and it's terrible.
Yeah,
it's ridiculous to me. Like, it's, you can make your own money and put it in the bank if you want someone to hold it, but you getting pimped out, it's just terrible.
And you got to throw money at the house too, right? What's the percentage you have to tip the house?
Well, my tip out is $75.
Oh, okay. It's not bad.
Yeah,
it's not a percentage then.
No,
that's good. You have a big night. Say you make, you know, $1,000 in a night, or $2,000, $5,000, $6,000, $7,000. Mm-hmm. You don't got to give them 10%. You just got to give them $75.
No, yeah.
That's great. True or false? There's no sex in the champagne room.
False.
Correct. So most of the girls turning tricks. Some of them turn them in the club. Some of them outside, after hours.
Right, they
make plans to link up or whatever.
Right.
What's the most money you made in one night?
$14,000.
That's great. That's a good night. What'd you do with it?
I took a lot of trips.
Trips?
I took a lot of trips.
So speaking of taking trips, do you do the circuit? Do you dance on the circuit?
Yeah.
Do you hit Atlanta?
Mm-hmm.
You hit Houston?
Mm-hmm. No, I've never been to Houston. Never been to Houston.
Vegas?
No. I just go to, like, Orlando, Tampa.
Yeah, Tampa's big. I know.
Where have else I been?
New Orleans?
Not New Orleans, no. Atlanta.
Where in Atlanta?
Blue Flame.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've been there before. I mean, wherever outside of Florida, like I get booked to different things. Like for the Pro Bowl in Orlando, we got booked for a lot of rappers. So we was at Club Dream there, and they showed us a nice time. That was good.
So if you take a personal trip, like let's say you and your girl go on a trip, mm-hmm. and you're on vacation, do you just all of a sudden be like, I'm going to work at the club tonight and just go to a strip club and work at a club?
No.
It's planned in advance. So if you're on vacation, you're on vacation.
I'm on vacation.
But if it's a working trip, it's two different things.
Yeah, it's two different things. Okay. Yeah, definitely.
What do you make per year? Is it vary? Like every year completely different, or is it about the same? I mean, you say you've been doing it like 6 years?
Yeah, probably longer than that.
Is it a huge difference?
I lost count. Totally, because 1 year it could be great, and then next year it'd be, you know, it's not so good. So I can't tell you what I make a year. I mean, I make a lot of money, but I can't just, I'm not the type of person to be like, okay, I made this.
You don't keep track of it?
No, because fast money goes fast.
Do you save any money?
Sometimes.
You could use a little help saving?
No, I don't need any.
You don't even want to save?
I mean, let me ask you a question on your show.
Ask me anything.
If you were to die tomorrow, everything that you owe, everything that you pay for, everything that you have, where would it go?
Now, that's a good question. And I would feel good that I could leave something behind for whoever needed it, whether it was my girlfriend or my family or my brother and his kids. I don't have any kids now.
Besides your family, we're talking about you.
Yeah, I mean, I don't... What do you mean?
Like, beside anybody that you're related to, you work hard for it, it's your mm-hmm. money, it's your thing. Where would you think that your things would go beside... Because when you die, your family fight over your things.
Right.
So... That's what I'm saying. Beside, if it wasn't your family, where would it go? Would you want it to be in the casket with you? Or?
Nah. You can't die with it. Exactly. You can't bring it with you.
You can't bring it with you. So I think like that. I just think that with me, when I die, I just think I'm just living my best life right now.
I hear you. But let's talk about... Now, I travel the world. Believe me, I spend money. But I'm also... I like to save. Mm-hmm. Because you never know when that cash cow... is going to run out of milk. Mm-hmm. So someone like you, you work on your appearance.
Right.
You're not going to look like that forever.
I know.
So when you're 50, 55, how are you going to make money?
Well, right now I have a job too. I'm just not a dancer.
Okay. What do you do? Okay. I'd love to hear about that.
I'm a store manager at a store. I'm not going to say okay. at a store, but I'm a store manager. I really just got off of work and I came... So it's like I'm not just holding on to the script world life. Like I have to go outside. You know, I love money so much that I'm going to make it come in all ways.
Yeah.
So I
multiple
have a real job
multiple streams of
too.
Income. That's right. Important.
I have a real job too.
Do you have a 401k or any mm-hmm. type of retirement plan mm-hmm. through your managing job?
Right.
Not through any of the strip club stuff.
No.
It's interesting. Now, I don't have a conventional job either, so I understand. Believe me. It's interesting to me, though, to talk to somebody else who makes money in an unconventional way.
Right.
Have you ever been followed home or stalked by customers?
Too much. To the point where it's scary.
I'm sure.
It's very scary. But, yeah, I've been stalked a lot to the point that I had to change my number.
So, they see you at the club. They clearly start to like you or whatever. And then they find out, like, where you live or what neighborhood you're in. They start, like, looking for you, kind of? Or do they just straight up follow you home from work?
I had one time that I was walking outside the club. I walked to my car, and he was just standing at the car. So I'm like, okay.
Now, don't you have security that walks you to your car every night, though?
No.
At some places, not at all places?
I mean, if you could tell a security guard, hey, I'm leaving, can you walk me to my car? But... See, I leave when I have enough money. So the security guard's probably still in the club. The club is still going on. So I just, you know, just walk out. And that night I just walked out and he was by my car. So I'm like, what are you doing? So he was like, oh, I just want to, you know, make sure you get home safe or whatever. And I'm like, we're not doing that. So I was so scared that I went back in the club, and then the security guards was like, you know, just let us know when you're leaving or whatever. And when I left and drove off, he was behind me. When he was behind me, he put the high beam lights and was following me a little bit. So I was like,
this did you recognize him from inside? Like, was he getting dances from you or anything? Or?
Yeah, he got dances from me, but it wasn't like a couple hundred bucks to stalk me. He's just like, oh, you remind me of my ex-wife. You're so beautiful. You're so beautiful. And then, you know, some people are very pervertish, and some people are like hornballs. So it was kind of crazy.
Yeah, I've heard stories about that type of stuff.
Yeah.
So how do you keep your body looking like that? Do you work out? You got surgeries? Any of the above?
Yeah, I work out every day. Every day I work. I'm just
on the pole. Besides the pole.
No, I don't work out. I had got surgery done, but I got my titties done.
Okay.
But I do eat healthy a lot, but I don't work out at all.
You play sports growing up?
I ran track. I was
very gonna say fast. Jamaican from Canada. Like, that's like big up there.
Mm-hmm. I ran fast, so I ran track when I was young.
My girl ran track.
I don't know how fast I am now, but I ran track then, yeah.
What about iPhones and people taking videos for social media and stuff at the club? I know they're not supposed to, but what do you do if you see that?
I'll probably get off stage, or I'll probably tell the security.
Okay.
Because it's... But, like, with me, I'm so secretive about other people uploading. It's not good when someone else uploading, you don't know that you're uploading.
Right. I've had a lot of, like, athletes on and stuff on the show, and they talk about, like, they're at dinner and people sneaking pictures of them while they're eating or something like that. And it's, if you want to get a picture with me, feel free to stop and ask, and I'll take a picture with
definitely.
You. But don't be sneaking, like, it's corny and it's creepy.
It is creepy.
What's your favorite song to dance to? You got like a favorite that kind of you just turn up whenever it comes on?
Meek Mill's have a nice song that
I know.
He got. Yeah, I like Meek Mill's and
a lot of energy.
You know, it's so many rappers, they rap the same now. It's like the same. It sounds the same, so I really can't, you know the difference. But Meek Mill's has a nice song that all the girls like to dance to.
What about women? Because down here, different parts of the country, strip clubs are very different. The culture is very different. Mm-hmm. I grew up in Boston. In Boston, the strip clubs, like, it's like a bunch of creeps sitting around just staring at women. Which, it's like that in a lot of parts of the country. But in Miami, in Atlanta, in Houston, it's a party. It's people watching the game on the TV, watching the girls on the stage, playing pool. You know, it's like it's like going out to a bar or a club.
Right.
It's just a social night. It's a social scene with naked people around you. Mm-hmm. In Miami, a lot of women go to the strip club to hang out. Mm-hmm. Whether they like women or don't like women. You know, they could be into women, they might not be into women. But do they tip good? Do you like it when women are there? Do you think... Because some places, they charge women extra to get in the door.
Get in, right. But to me, I'm not going to say I hate when women come to the strip club, but it's like 50-50. Like, you have a couple comes to the strip club, and her husband is so horny to get a lap dance or to tip a stripper, but the wife is next to him, so he's, you know, he's just holding his composure, and he doesn't really do the same thing that he does when he comes by
himself.
He's holding back until he sees his wife. You know,
she gets busy
grabbing ass and stuff like that. Then he's like, okay, she's grabbing ass, let me grab ass. You know, like, that's how it is. But with girls, some girls that just come to the strip club, I'm glad you asked this question, and they just sit there and stare at us. And it's like, it's like they're degrading us, and it's ridiculous because you come to our
Because you know they're kind of thinking like, okay, this is what they do in here. Kind of like they're like looking into their world, your world, and seeing what her husband or boyfriend does when he's not with her.
Right, right.
Oh, this is what you do. Okay, I'm going to use this
later on. Right, right, in the bed. Right. Yep. You know, but I don't care if you, but I just feel like if you come to the strip club with your significant other, you know, tip us, you know. It don't hurt to tip us even a dollar. One thing about a dancer, if you show that you tip in $1, it only takes $1 for us to appreciate you and, you know, your significant other, but you have girls that come, get across their legs, they got their mouth all looking all crazy, and they're just mad at the whole world. And it's uncomfortable for us because we're both women. So it's like, are you degrading me or what are you doing? Like, you're just staring there. It's a lot of women come to the club and just stare at us.
So most of the clubs that you've mentioned that I'm familiar with are black strip clubs. Have you worked in any white strip clubs?
No.
Because they're very different. They're very different.
I mean, I got hired at a white strip club, but I didn't go. Because I'm going to be honest. I wear two pieces, like stoned out, two pieces, nice outfit. In the white club, they wear gowns.
It's corny.
Right. So I'm not judging anybody on what they do, but I can't get jiggy with the gown on. Because it's like I'm going out. It's like, I put on a gown and I'm going out with a friend. And it's who's going to take me serious? But that's how the white strip club is. And I can't do that.
So you were talking about how you view the Miami strip clubs as almost more like a social thing for you.
Yes.
Now, do you go there and kind of work and kind of party?
I mean, if they're having a big night or something, I'll go work. I'm not going to lie. But lately, it's just been a hangout spot for me. Like,
but when you're hanging out, are you still working or you're there hanging out in your own time?
No, I just go to work. I don't hang out at all. It's in the Miami strip clubs.
Okay.
I just go to work.
When it comes to the social aspect of being at work, how do the girls get along? I know there's a lot of different, there's different dynamics, different personalities, and then you got the girls who have been there a long time who are kind of like running the show, and then there's the new girls who come from out of town or maybe from a different club and they're trying to get your money, and there's a lot of competition in there.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's drainful sometimes because you have to worry about who watching who, you know, it's a lot of dancers. I can say fuck.
You can say anything.
It's a lot of dancers fuck.
You can say pussy or vagina or dick or penis, anything.
Okay, well, it's a lot of strippers have sex with the clients. So they had sex probably last week. So he comes in the club again and he sees another beautiful girl and he wants to dance her. But since she gave up the pussy last week, she's going to hang around him. And then he sees someone else that's attractive. So that's conflict between the girls. It's like, oh, I was with him yesterday. And, oh, well, he wanted to dance me. And then they're just, like, conflict. Or, you know, or it's just ridiculous. Like, the only thing that strippers really fight about is, like, drama, money, you know, stuff like that. He say, she say, stuff like that.
So what if one of your regulars comes in and you're used to him going to you and then he goes to someone else? Is that, like, her fault? Or you put that on him, or is that just, it don't matter?
It's nobody's fault because I don't never take these customers serious at all. Because once it's my money, then it was my money, then I'll let them go. I'm not going to take it serious. I'm not that type of person to take it serious. Like the saying is, like, if you could dwell on it for 5 minutes and it's not going to matter in the next 4 years, then it doesn't make sense. I'm not going to dwell on it.
Have you ever fought a girl over customers about something that happened?
No.
You didn't sound too convinced.
I had to think about it.
Yeah.
I've had me cuss somebody out.
You've had some issues, but never had to.
Yeah, but I never had a fight.
Throw hands or anything.
No. I'm not that type of person.
Poaching customers.
Yeah, I never did that.
A lot of girls like to pop pills and stuff while they work.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of that. Molly and MDMA and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Is that common or is that?
I mean, everybody's doing it. Everybody down to the customers, the bartenders, everybody's doing it. And I'm not gonna say nobody's doing it in the club. Everybody is getting on. If they're not smoking a joint, they're not on Molly's, they're not on, they're on the new thing Percocets, they're on something. But I don't take any drug. I don't smoke or nothing like that. I drink, but I don't do no drugs.
Do you prefer it when customers buy you drinks? Do you like to get a couple drinks in you when you're there?
Yeah, it'll be nice of him to offer a drink. That's nice of him.
That doesn't happen a lot, or does it?
Yeah, it does.
Okay.
That one thing about guys, they do offer to buy you a drink. Yeah. Some guys will offer to buy you a drink and don't want to dance. They just want to just buy you a drink.
Yeah, I'd be more prone to do that. Yeah. I mean, I'm not a big lap dance guy. Okay. Really not. But speaking of that, do you ever get turned on when you give a guy a lap dance? Like you might see a guy that you're like, oh, okay, he wants to lap dance, whatever. And then you find yourself being like, I'm kind of attracted to this guy.
I don't know. I mean...
Why is that such a tough question?
Because sometimes, I see a guy, he's nice looking, he smells good. I don't get turned on. It's just that I love to dance guys that look good and smell good. Like, okay. I hate to dance the guy who just got off of work, he smells like garbage, and, you know.
Or a guy who smells like cigarettes, right, or something. Right,
or, you know, you just smell the sun on him and stuff like that. So it's a good thing to dance guys that smell good.
Everybody has a price. Mm-hmm. What's your price?
Of what?
To do anything.
A guy comes in the club and he
says, you're the most beautiful woman I've ever seen.
I don't do anything in the club.
He says, I want your number. I'll give you X amount of dollars if you meet me at my hotel tonight.
I'm not going to the hotel.
Meet you at my crib or I don't know.
Okay, I'm not going to sound racist. I'm going to say I'm only attracted to like Italian guys or guys that has, you know, I could say like has like businesses or something that has, you know, that well, has this something is, this to is that lose.
Guy though. This is that guy though. It's a okay, handsome well, if that's a, Italian man, businessman in a suit, and he comes in and he says, "I'll give you $1. I'll give you $100. I'll give you $10,000." Where does the number stop?
It depends on whatever I'm doing. I don't have a specific number to be like, oh, I'm doing this and I'm doing that. It depends on what he wants me to do. It depends on if he want to dance
He wants sex.
Okay, but I'm not doing that.
There's no price.
No.
But there's a price that got you naked.
Because that's my job. We're talking about my job where I have to, if my lights go off tomorrow, I have to pay my lights. But... If I have to have sex with you and I rather could go in the club, I'm not just gonna have, this is the whole thing with me. I'm not gonna have sex with you because you offer a price. Because you could be HIV positive.
Sure.
You could have gonorrhea. You could have something and then my life will be.
But that's just like any other guy. Like you could go on a date with a guy and think this guy's great and you're falling in love and have sex with him. That all applies to him too.
Yeah, but I'm gonna, one thing about me, I'm gonna get you, I've never slept with a guy unprotected. And if I take you that serious, you're gonna go get checked out.
Hold up. You've never had unprotected sex in your life?
Not in my life.
Oh, what did you? That's but what saying, I thought like, you just
if,
said.
Okay, guys from the club. Oh, like if I meet you and we have sex, like 4 months from now, you're gonna put on a condom. I'm not okay. gonna jump on a raw dick.
Agreed. That's a good thing.
You have to get checked out.
Okay.
Period. That's just how I am.
But in a relationship, it's different.
In a relationship, I'm gobbling balls. I'm doing everything.
Okay. Cool. We like that. I did some research and found some statistics.
Okay.
You tell me, this is a test. You tell me if these are true or false.
Okay.
Okay. Because you're a professional dancer.
Right.
So you should know about professional dancers. True or false, 10% of professional dancers consider what they do prostitution. True or false?
False.
Do you think the percentage will be higher or lower?
Lower. Better be lower.
It's true. 10% of strippers. This was taken from a big group. They did a study.
Okay.
10% of strippers think that they consider it prostitution. That's a fact. 1/3 of strippers are actually doing it to pay for college. True or false? You know how they all say, I'm just stripping to get through college.
No, it's false. Because I see a lot of girls that they say they was paying for college and they're still there 5 years from now. I mean...
Right?
Right. So I thought so too. What college you go to?
But it's true. 33% of strippers are actually paying for college. Only 10% of professional dancers are married. True or false?
True.
That is true.
No one takes us serious. Everybody thinks we're hoes.
50% of strippers have dated a customer. True or false? Like, really true. Dated.
True.
It's false. It's only 20%.
Really? Oh,
I mean,
my
I think messed around with is different. That's a whole different statistic.
Oh,
had a relationship.
Oh, like, I thought you were saying, like, mess with the client.
Like, have you ever had a real, like, a long-term relationship with a client?
Yes.
Okay, so you met him there, you got to know him, blah, 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 and all that, mm-hmm. and found love and all that.
Right.
Okay. Well, they say 20%. Up to 90% of strippers have dealt with some sort of sexual abuse as a child. True or false?
That's true.
I do want to say true, too. But I just don't want to, like, make it so bad that everybody's dancing because there was abuse. Can I go with, like, both answers?
I think we know the answer. It's true.
Yeah. Unfortunately, it's true. I hear stories that a lot of people was abused. Like, right now in the club that I work at, it's probably, like, 3 girls was abused. So
yeah.
I didn't want
to
say.
It's probably more, but 3 have opened up to you about it.
Exactly. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's sad.
It is.
About 90%. Of professional dancers were raised in a religious home. True or false?
True.
That is true. It's a high percentage.
Mm-hmm.
Are you religious?
Yes.
Yeah. What?
I'm Baptist.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
I was going to say, you're Jamaican. You could be Jehovah's Witness Seventh-day Adventist.
No.
50% of professional dancers have kids. True or false?
True.
False.
Are you serious?
20%.
Well, you know what? Let me say something to me.
You
got to
think of the really young ones.
I was just going to say, you have girls that's
they're
spread out of
fresh
high school,
faced.
18, and they're just in there dancing.
Yeah. You don't have kids.
Yeah.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
How old?
Well, it's not really mine. It's just, I don't have any, but I do. So.
You've never given birth to a child?
No.
Okay. Do you have a boyfriend?
No.
Do you have a husband?
No.
Huh. It's interesting. There's a child in the mix somehow.
It's a long story.
Okay. That's fine. You don't want to talk about it?
No.
Okay. I will respect that. If you do want to talk about it, feel free.
Okay.
Okay. We're done with the statistical exam.
Okay.
We're moving on to the do's and don'ts at a strip club.
No, don't do it. Please don't do it.
Tell me if guys should do this or don't do this. These are things that I've heard guys do. I've had, when I was young, older guys, they bring you out to the strip club and they tell you this is what they like. Oh, you should do this or you should do that or don't do this. You tell me if this is a do or a don't.
Okay.
Okay. Make eye contact with her while she's on stage.
Yes.
That's a good thing?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, JJ. JJ gave us that tip right there. What about guys asking you for your number after a lap dance?
No.
That's a don't.
Yeah. I didn't give you a lap dance for my number. Let me offer you my number.
Yeah, that's like completely up to you because all the girls are going to be showing the guys attention, so that doesn't mean anything.
Right.
Right. What about, okay. Oh, man, I'll never forget this. Big Cousin Sil. He said they like it when you blow on it. So you're dancing in front of me and I'm blowing on it. I'm blowing air at you.
No.
Don't blow on it.
No.
That was his thing. He said blow on it.
He's a jackass. How would you blow on me? No.
Hey, I'm just telling you.
That's gonna irritate her.
Yeah.
No, don't do that.
What about when they ball up ones and throw them like that? And don't make it rain. They're not falling. They're throwing them.
I mean, anything is appreciative, so yes.
Okay. Yeah. That's still okay?
It's still okay.
So,
yeah.
Like, I know at like Coco's, when they're up here and you're back here and you want to get it up there, like, because if you just throw it here, it's going to come back down where you're sitting.
Right.
You know,
so
you want to throw it
up
there.
Right.
And then it, like, lands behind the bar back there
right.
And you'll pick it up.
Exactly. Yeah. So that's...
But I know a lot of times people, don't throw it. Like, that's disrespectful. But it's like... When you ball it up and throw it, but that's...
I mean, do you want the tip or not?
Exactly.
Right.
It doesn't hurt.
Right.
What about touching during lap dances?
Touching what?
Touching you. Like, where do they cut the line off? So you're sitting on me, and you're dancing on me, and what, I can put my hands here.
Right.
But don't put it, like, on any private parts.
No private parts, titties, ass. No private parts.
Yeah, no insertions. No.
No, none of that. Okay. You can touch my titties and you can touch like my side and my ass, but no private parts. No.
Okay.
Because you gotta remember, our pussy is sensitive, so you know.
All those different.
You're digging and you're, you know, it breaks out and, you know, like
bacteria.
You have, yeah. So you can't just dig and you just smoke like 100 cigarettes before you came here. You know, like it's just nasty. So.
Agreed. You have been arrested?
Yes.
Anything good?
No, my license was suspended. He took me to jail.
Not your dancing license.
Not my DL.
Your other DL.
My license was suspended. He took me to jail. And I got it got thrown out. So I didn't even face any charges.
Did
so.
You have to go to county though? Sit there overnight or anything?
No, it basically you went in and you know, you bond right. If you have the money on you, you could just bond out.
You live up this way, or are you Miami?
I stay in Broward.
Okay, I don't need your address. I'm not
no,
trying
I'm
to follow you.
I'm definitely not gonna say my address, but I stay in Broward.
Okay. What other interests do you have? What do you like to do besides make money?
The casino. I love going to the casino.
Where do you go? Hard Rock?
No.
No.
Coconut Creek. I like to go there. I love to eat good food.
We'll get into that. We're gonna get to that in a minute.
Okay.
What's the end game? What do you want to get out of this? Are you saving money for a home? Are you saving money to start a family? Do you have an end game? Do you want to start your own business?
I have my own business right now. So.
Lashes?
Yeah.
Okay. I think I saw on your Instagram lashes.
I have my Meek lashes that I'm selling. It's doing pretty good. I have the guy from Drag Race.
Drag shows.
Yeah, it's RuPaul.
RuPaul's Drag Race.
Yeah, and like he's sponsoring my lashes right now. So you know, I have that going on. I have a lot of dancers that wear my eyelashes. So it's like I'm trying to start that. And you know, add on to like wigs and hair pieces onto it, but you know, I'm just taking my time.
Would you like to open a shop eventually?
Yes. Yes.
Do nails and lashes and stuff
mm-hmm.
like that.
Mm-hmm.
Who's the best stripper you've ever seen? Can you think of one that kind of blew your mind? She was just crazy skilled and the most professional dancer.
I don't go off of skills. I go off of who's the sexiest dancer that
all
I've
that.
Ever seen. I mean,
anybody come to mind?
I like Cardi B. Cardi B was, you know, she's sexy and she's blunt. Like she say anything she meet. I like her.
Right, personality.
And I like Ross ex girlfriend. I forgot her name.
Oh, Memphis chick. That Memphis chick.
Yeah, she's Lila Galore.
Yeah, Lila Galore.
Lila Galore. She's so Galore. Yeah, she's so sexy to me. Yeah. Like, I really like her.
Yeah.
So those are the dancers that I really like, you know, because they got out the game and they're doing things to better themselves. I just don't like, you know, girls that's just doing tricks and pulls and flipping off. You know, you have to.
That's what I'm saying, the tip drills of the world and stuff.
Yeah, but, you know, she's still in the game. So, you know, I just like girls that got into the game and got out the game and now they're, you know, $500,000 richer or $1 million richer. So that's where I really want to go with my career.
You ever worked at KOD? Speaking of that.
Yeah.
So at KOD, I do enjoy when they go up to the roof
mm-hmm.
and hang from the rafters. You done that?
Yeah, I could do that.
Yeah, see that stuff to me, that when I think of skill, that's all I think of is that. Like the pole is one thing, but like there's a lot of like difficulty, technical difficulty, and danger involved in that.
It is.
That shit's crazy. The first time I saw it, I was like,
I think that the girls that goes to the top deserve more than probably $500. Like they get thrown at them, but it's our, you know, they're dancing and they're entertaining people. But I just think they deserve so much more, but they're not getting paid to what they do.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, I wouldn't do it. I don't do it anymore. I know how to do a lot of tricks, but I just don't do anything anymore.
What about fight night? Did you ever go during fight night?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Do you ever fight?
No.
No.
I leave it to the other girls from the hood that wants to fight.
All right.
Knock each other's teeth out or whatever.
You've been to... I had a little note here. Man, I realized I've been to strip clubs in all different countries.
Mm-hmm.
You've been to strip clubs in different countries?
Puerto Rico.
I went out there too, yeah.
I went to Puerto Rico, and you know what? It made me appreciate my strip life here. Even the managers, the owners, they're all making sure you're okay. And we only spent like $300. But Puerto Rico, they appreciate what, you know, every customer that goes in there. They very appreciate. Like, the girl's really going to get up there and do a split, kick, jump. They're going to, you know, seduce you. It's very, very, very nice in Puerto Rico.
Yeah. The weirdest strip club experience I ever had was in the Philippines. It was midget boxing and strippers.
Really?
Yeah. So you had like little dudes, little midget dudes fighting each other. And then there was like strippers around the ring. And it was,
really?
That was pretty wild. That was in the Philippines.
That's crazy.
All right. Let's close it out. I got a couple more top five rappers that are alive.
Okay. Number five will be Tupac. Number four, Biggie. Number three. Oh, DMX. I like the old DMX.
It's funny you say that because I was having a conversation with somebody about this. If DMX had put out those first two albums,
mm-hmm.
and then like died, he would be a legend, yeah, like Biggie.
Right, but then he got
hooked on crack and started putting out this other stuff. And isn't that crazy though? He could put out like 50 albums and Biggie put out two albums.
Mm-hmm.
And Biggie's still the greatest.
Yeah.
It's interesting. But those two albums were
as
good as anybody's, right?
Because he really was a dope person. I also like Pimp C.
Yep.
MJG and Pimp C. I like them. I like Scarface.
Well, now you hit six. You
gotta cut one of them out. Well.
You only go five. This is a serious question on the Keep It In A Hundo podcast. Everybody gets asked this question. So you going with... We got DMX, Biggie, and Tupac for sure. Who are your last two?
You know what? I'm going to do Biggie, Tupac, Lil Wayne.
Wayne had three classic albums. And then he did a bunch of crap after that.
Yeah, I like Lil Wayne. And I also like... I don't know, I'm an R&B girl. Like, I love R&B. That's all I love. So I really don't, like, listen to rap. Like, I'm just, like, an R&B person. But those people that I named...
Okay,
we're going to take out Pimp C and Scarface. Slick Rick was a good one.
All right. And that's old school.
Yeah. Slick Rick was... He was a good person. Yeah.
All right. And now to the final question. What's your death row meal? What are you eating?
Vic and Angelo's.
Is that an Italian place in Broward? I feel like I've heard of it, but never been there.
It's so good. Like, I love Vic and Angelo's.
It's in Delray?
Mm-hmm.
What are you eating there?
I'll probably get their sampler. It comes with calamari and shrimp with the lime sauce. And then I'll do the filet mignon with the broccoli. Yeah.
What are you drinking?
Apple juice.
Apple juice?
Yeah.
You drink alcohol?
No, not like, no really.
Not often? Only at work?
I probably take a shot of Hennessy.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's it, Diamond.
Okay.
You did all right.
Okay.
Best blonde I ever had on the show.
I better be.
I hope you enjoyed my conversation with Diamond. We recorded that at an undisclosed strip club in South Florida. You can find her all over Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach. Good luck. As I said, she's on Instagram. It's gorgeous_diamond_foreign. When we finished the podcast, the first thing she asked me was, why didn't you ask me my favorite position? So I apologize if that's what you were looking for. But I told her it was a podcast about stripping and strip club culture and her lifestyle. It wasn't a sex podcast. It can be. Maybe next time. We can definitely have her back on Keeping It A Hundo if You guys really enjoyed it. I got an update on Slick, last week's guest. His episode of Power premieres on July 8th. It's episode 2 of this season's Power. Power comes back on July 1st. His episode is July 8th. Thanks to the booty knocking Moroccan Habib for the shout out on last week's episode, sharing it. Please continue to download it and subscribe to it and share it on social media. If you like what you hear, I'd love to get more people on board and I'd love to get more comments. Scroll down under my episodes and you'll see a section where you can rate and review me. I would greatly appreciate that if you haven't done it already. I know I mentioned Clean John from last season, episode 1. We'll be making an appearance this season as well. He's undergoing a makeover right now. He just had his teeth pulled, his remaining teeth, and he's getting dentures. I'm telling you, this guy's cleaning up. I'm pretty sure he just hopped on Tinder too. So he's making moves. He's been taking selfies. So we're going to have him on soon to talk about life off the streets because he's not on them anymore. Next week's guest will be Chase Scott. He's a friend of mine. He University of Miami graduate, played football. He's also the Miami Heat team chaplain. He's a published author of 2 books as well. So it will be a very different episode than this week's. He talks about how men should be treating women and the new guy code, which is the name of one of his books, and about abstinence as a heterosexual male and how difficult it is and why he believes it's the only way for him to live. So that's next week on Keepin' It A Hundo. Thanks for listening.
Look, I be riding through my old hood, but I'm in my new whip. Yes, same old attitude, but I'm on that new shit. Yeah. They say they gon' ride me, see me never do shit. Never. Cause they know that's the reason they gon' end up on the news clip. Or tomorrow on my wrist, bust down. Blink. We popping bottles like I scored a winning touchdown. Score. Remember me dead broke, blow. Look at me up now. My city from South Philly back to uptown. Thank God all these bottles I pop, all this paper I've been getting, all these models I pop. I done sold 100,000 for my album got dropped. And I'm only 23, I'm the shit now. Look at me, look at me. I'm a boss like my nigga Rose. Hey, shorty asked me for a check. I told that bitch like no way. Cause I made it from the bottom, it was never no way. And I never had a job, you know I had to sell, yeah. Bitch, I'm a boss. I call a shit.